descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And our three Hail Marys are the virtue of faith, hope, and charity. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Our first joyful mystery is the Annunciation of the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Our second joyful mystery is the Visitation. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. Our third joyful mystery is the birth of Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need of thy mercy. Our fourth joyful mystery is the presentation of our Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. Our fifth joyful mystery is finding the child Jesus in the temple. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning beneath this valley of tears. Turn, thou most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant we beseech thee that by meditating upon these mysteries of the most holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Lord.
March 24th at 6:30 a.m. here at St. John's. The citywide Stations of the Cross will be on Friday, March 25th at Transfiguration Church at 7 p.m. The Mary and Gil Pasta Cheese Dinner will be Saturday, March 26th after the 4:30 Mass in the Social Hall. We have limited seating, so please make sure you sign up at the entrances of the church. Our bereavement support group will meet on Tuesday, March 22nd at 6:30 in the rectory meeting rooms. Please use the back door of the church. And just one more reminder, they are taking orders for Easter bread at the church entrances as well. Our processional hymn this afternoon is number 737. All are welcome. Number 737.
From the book of Exodus. Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law, Jethro, the priest of Midian. Leaving the flock across the desert, he came to Horeb, a mountain of God. There, an angel of the Lord appeared to Moses in fire flaming out of a bush. As they looked on, he was surprised to see that the bush, though on fire, was not consumed. So Moses decided, I must go over to look at this remarkable sight and see why the bush is not burned. When the Lord saw him coming over to look at it more closely, God called out to him from the bush, "Moses, Moses." He answered, "Here I am." God said, "Come no nearer. Remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you stand is holy ground. I am the God of your fathers," he continued, "the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob." Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look at God. But the Lord said, "I have witnessed the affliction of my people in Egypt, and I have heard their cry of complaint against their slave drivers. So I know well what they are suffering. Therefore, I have come down to rescue them from the hands of the Egyptians and lead them out of that land into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey." Moses said to God, "But when I go to the Israelites and say to them, 'The God of your fathers has sent me to you,' if they ask me, 'What is his name?' what am I to tell them?" God replied, "I am who am." Then he added, "This is what you shall tell the Israelites. I am who sent me to you." God spoke further to Moses, "Thus shall you say to the Israelites, 'The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever. Thus am I to be remembered through all generations.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Desire evil things as they did. Do not grumble as some of them did, and suffered death by the destroyer. These things happened to them as an example, and they have been written down as a warning to us, upon whom the end of ages has come. Therefore, whoever thinks he is standing secure should take care not to fall. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We've heard the old cliche, sin is sin. You know, we try to put sin in different categories. You know, well, there's venial sin, there's, you know, there's mortal sin. Well, this sin is not quite as bad as that sin, and this sin, well, you know, I really didn't mean it. And this sin, I can really, you know, we try to, in our minds, we try to put sin in a category. Well, sin is sin, period. That's what Jesus is saying in the gospel today. But he used many different examples to show that. The Galileans, how they suffered, you know, that they had more sin than the other people. The person, you know, who was the parable, as he mentioned here, of Siloam. Now the tower fell on certain people, that they had more sin than the other people. We don't know that. The bottom line, as Jesus is teaching us, is that sin is sin. And there's always room for conversion. And there's always room for repentance. That's the most important thing. Think about this, because when we sin, there's so many things that go on in our minds and in our hearts. You know, most of the sins that we commit are done by this. Lack of charity. So think about it. You know, we have two eyes. We have two ears, we have two hands. You know, the eyes help us to look and to see. The ears help us to listen and to discern. And the hands help us to do what is good with our hands. God forbid if we had two mouths. Imagine that.
You know, God gave us two things for a reason. If he gave us two mouths, we'd be in trouble. I mean, big trouble. But we'd be talking out of both sides, going at it left and right. He knew what he was doing. But he gave us an opportunity. Forgiveness is so important in our lives. And this season of Lent gives us a chance, well, gives us a second chance, and a third chance, and a 50th chance to receive God's mercy. Because it's never too late. It's never too late to reach out to him and to seek that repentance and that feel that conversion that takes place in our lives because we do place our trust in him. You know, even the things in Scripture, you know, even in the Old Testament, you know, God always gave the people a second chance in some strange ways. When Noah went to the Ninevites, you know, God just said, I'm going to destroy this whole city because they're terrible people. But Jonah, listening to God's word, went through the whole city and said, repent, turn away from sin. What did they do? They sat in ashes, put on purple sackcloth. What did God do? He relented. Why? Because of his mercy. That great mercy of God. Even the mercy from the cross to say, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. The power of God's mercy. Well, we got to ask ourselves, do we need God's mercy today? All of us? Do we need forgiveness? Each of us? Do we need a conversion experience personally in our lives? We need to search for that. Because this season of Lent gives us that time. You know, that's why we have confessions, you know, three nights a week plus on Saturday throughout the parishes in the city of Rome. Like I said before, on Monday and Tuesday. On Monday it's at St. Paul's, on Tuesday at St. Peter's from, you know, 5 until 6. And here on Wednesday from 4:30 to 5:30. Repentance. Conversion. God's mercy. Lord, I'm sorry. Very easy. And we all need to do it. All of us. I'm not just throwing this out at you and saying, look at Father, he's so good. No. We all need that. We all need the mercy of God and that change of heart. You know, how many times over this past week, you know, we sat in front of the TV set watching the news and all that's going on in the Ukraine. And we said to ourselves, oh boy, see, there's those two mouths going at it again. Judgmentalism, all those types of things. We want to kick the TV set. Believe me, I got a big TV, I want to hit it. But we ask God's mercy. We ask for his forgiveness. So today, I encourage you to think about your own personal life. Think about how a conversion experience can take place. Think about forgiveness. And turn to the Lord. Seek reconciliation. Remember, we always used to talk about the Easter duty. Going to confession before Easter or before Pentecost. Well, that hasn't changed. You know, we need that mercy. Young people and old people alike. You know, we don't see a lot of the teenagers or those in their 20s or so on because they're busy. We all need it. We all need the mercy of God. I think the Lord's listening to us this evening as the sun just came out. You know, I mean, how quickly our minds switch. But that's how he listens to us. Let us take that opportunity because the time is now, not tomorrow. Not next week, not, well, you know, maybe I'll do it in January of next year, whatever. The time is now for us to seek forgiveness, repentance, and conversion to begin anew. To use the hands that we have to build up the body of Christ. To use the eyes that we have to see the goodness and the love and the peace in each person around us. to use our ears to listen to the goodness of Jesus Christ. Now is the time for us to turn to the Lord. Now is the time for us to seek forgiveness. May God bless you. Together now we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, the true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. To him all things were made. For us man and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray. Calling upon the loving Father, let us lift our needs to those and those of the world.
For the Church, may God's love and mercy be abundant upon her. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are entrusted with leadership roles in government, business, or law, that they may exercise their authority with kindness and mercy, especially to those who are most unlikely to receive it from others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose hearts are burdened by sin and who struggle to trust in God's mercy and forgiveness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, may the Lord's teaching shape our lives and His grace conform us to His heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the war and suffering in the Ukraine, that the tender mercy of God will guide all to the way of peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they find peace and eternal rest in the presence of God in heaven, especially Violet Pinster and Linda Longto, who had their funeral masses this past week, and for Marie D'Ambrosi, John and Lucille Venturo, Joseph Fusco, the deceased members of the DiBardino family, Anna Ernenwine, Mary Spado, Bertha Carrero, Joseph Parisi, and Vincenzo D'Antonio, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions in our prayers group of prayer, and for your own personal intentions, which you may add in silence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious Father, receive the prayers that we lift up to you this day. We ask that you grant them in the name of your Son, Jesus, who is our Lord and our Savior, forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus.
When supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me."
Amen.
pray our family prayer. O God, Father of all people, in your divine plan, create the family as a special sign of your love. Your Son, Jesus, walked among us in the family of Mary and Joseph. They created a home in which the Word of God was feared, obeyed, and lived, where they grew in wisdom and grace, and gave of themselves unselfishly to God, their family, and others. But the Holy Family is our honor. Help us to keep you as the center of our lives and reflect our relationship with you in our homes. Bless and protect each of us, our families and our parish, all members of God's family. Send your peace upon us and grant us the grace to serve you and each other, that in doing so we may provide glory to you.
Prayer to St. Michael.
Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God renew him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the divine power, trust in the health, safe in all other evil spirits, who wander through the world seeking your wounded souls. Let us pray. As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven, and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a couple of announcements. Starting next Sunday, the ushers are going to go back to work. The ushers will be taking up the collection the way we used to 2 years ago. We're going to start having them use their, in our ministry a little bit more to take up the collection. Also, we will have the gifts be starting to bring up next week. So if you have a Mass intention, just see one of the ushers before Mass. If not, whoever's there first, you have the other ones are here. You know, bring them up. That's all we care about. Thirdly, we are in now to the middle of March, the first day of spring, I think it's tomorrow, if I'm not mistaken. The cemetery. Please, if you have Christmas ornaments or wreaths or things there, if you want them, please take them, because we're going to start next week cleaning up the cemetery and getting things ready for the spring, because we have spring burials, and we want to get the Christmas decorations out of there. It is in the middle of March now. So we have to expect some good weather too, where the snow is melted. So we ask you, please, if you leave them there, after a couple weeks, we will remove them. So just to let you know that. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Have a nice evening, everyone.
Our sessional hymn is number 730. Let there be peace on earth, number 730.
Turn out to our Blessed Lady for guidance and strength throughout this week as we pray. Hail Mary.